Breaking news, my lovely, wonderful people. It's happening. Tinubu's thoughtless announcement responsible for the misery the country is going through right now. Omoyele Sowore blast the newly inaugurated president of the country, Asiwaju Ahmed Bola Tinubu. Said the guy was thoughtless. You know, the announcement is he made. Said it's affecting every single person. You know, said this guy, you know, think, just talk bagada. See as they do, see as it don't affect everybody. Now the whole nation, you know, is going through, you know, what this guy has done. The filling stations are closed up. There is already huddling going on and what have you. So it's really terrible. It's really terrible to mention, but if it's terrible, things that are happening, it's really terrible. You know, so these are some of the things that are going on right now. Morally sure already don't blast President Alexei. You know, they think. You know, they think at all. If you think, you know, go do it till you do so. Because it is sad, very sad. You know, say so, you know, they inaugurate you. From that day, you don't start suffering in the country already. You don't start suffering in the country for the people already. Please don't forget to give us a thumbs up. Like us, share, subscribe. Let's get all the details. Tinubu's thoughtless announcement responsible for the sufferings of Nigerians. He has not even started. Omoyele Sowore, the presidential candidate of the African Action Congress, AAC, within the February 25th election, has lashed out at the president, Bola Ahmed Tinubu. This, he said, Tinubu's choice to finish the gas supply and to save his removal fuel subsidy without being thoughtful, thinking and properly applying the right things has affected every single one. Reacting to the reshuffling of queues, Sowore stated that Tinubu's thoughtless fuel subsidy remover announcement triggered fuel scarcity and price hike all over the country. Recall that at the very day of Tinubu's inauguration, he suddenly declared subsidy removed. The operations of petrol pump, which was costing 210 to 500 per liter, followed the affiliation of gas subsidy removed by Tinubu's administration. In a published by way of his verified Twitter day with the Tuesday announcement and all, Sowore said the nation elites don't care about Nigerians, and what they do is how they can make more business and money for themselves, he wrote. Asiwaju Ahmed Bola Tinubu thoughtless fuel subsidy removal announcement has already triggered fuel scarcity, the price going up all over the country. This is why Nigerians must understand that nothing good will come out of Nigerians' elites in and out of power. They are always after you. They don't care about you. Revolution now. So that's Omoyele Sowore. He don't blast the president-elect, say, or president, no longer president-elect, just swear I'm in. He said, you don't even think, Tinubu. Wait, you do your thoughts. You not think. You not properly give, you know, context to what you need to do. You just jump in, you know, into like a tornado. You just jump in and you jump out. He said, they do things like that. Nobody does things like that. You think about it. You sit down, analyze it, and know exactly what you're doing. Not this thing you just, what you did now is totally not acceptable. You know, it's totally not acceptable. You know, this is very terrible. This is very terrible, you know. Nigerians, we all just need to ensure that, you know, we turn away, you know, we turn away from this set of individuals and people who are not even willing already to bring about a change in this country. And really, truly speaking, what they are really doing and all that they are, you know, they are working for is themselves. They don't care about the people who are on the streets. Okay? You will be shocked. You'll be shocked, you know, the way things have gone in this country, all that is happening, it will really shock you. In fact, it's very scary to mention, but if you, it's really very, very scary, you know. So these are some of the things that are happening and why no one, you know, should sit back there and think that all of a sudden things are going to fall in place if we do not rise up and reject, you know, oppression being instigated at us by those who are supposed to be leading, you know, by those who are supposed to be leading. The country is seriously going through a lot, and all that is happening and all that is going on, it's a clear indication, you know, of how things have been and how things are and what we can do differently in ensuring that we turn this nation from the current spray, you know, of people who want to destroy it in every way humanly speaking possible. Nigerians needs, you know, a breath of fresh air. Nigeria needs the dawn of a new day. Nigeria needs something fresh, something unique to change the course of what is going on right now. The misdirection, you know, that held us for far too long needs to come to an end. Every single individual, every single one of us have got a part to play in ensuring that we change what is happening right now. Every single one of us. So nobody should allow the same thing over and over again to hold us down. This country is really in need of change. This country is really in need of, you know, we need to get off, you know, with all that is happening right now and put this country in the right direction in ensuring that, you know, things, you know, are really, really transformed. Nigeria is just like, you know, a nation, you know, who is just, you know, suffocating and crying for change and saying, I've had enough. Please, I've had enough. Can we change things right now? I've had enough. Okay. So this is what is happening. This is what is going on. Every single person, every single individual is watching, and we just want things, this whole thing to come to an end so that the country can sincerely and truly move forward. Okay. Long before now, a lot of persons, a lot of people have continued to say that, you know, they are for this, they are for that. But now that the whole elections are done and dusted, appointments and done and inauguration is done and dusted, appointment is the next thing. And that's why we need to really pray until God decide if who we have is our president or not. You know, we just need to keep praying, because whoever they appoint will affect the way things go. You know, even if a man has a mind to do something, those he has appointed into office, if they are not willing to work, it will affect the whole nation. So please don't forget to give us a thumbs up. Like us, share, subscribe. God bless. Have a fantastic and a lovely day. From us, it's bye for now. Bye-bye.